everybody! Welcome back, Scott, the Grillman Grippo!
Hey! How you guys doing? Season 3, can't believe it. Boy, we had a great time in Season 2, didn't we? We did everything from making matzo ball soup, to candying walnuts, to candying pecans, so you could actually say we did it all from soup to nuts. I gotta tell you, I got a ton of video on Season 2 if you haven't seen it, okay? And it's all step by step. And what I want to tell you is when I cook in this kitchen in today's episode, it's like you're standing in a cooking class, okay? I'm teaching you just like you're in a cooking class learning. So put the money back in your wallet and just watch this show for free, because we're going to get it on in Season 3. Not only do I have my episodes, and I have the quickies, and I have the test kitchen, I have another new segment that I'm going to be doing where I'm going to be making cocktails. And they're not going to be cocktails that are off the wall and outrageous. Some may be, but they're going to be everyday drinks that are made, and I'm going to show you how to make them the way I like them, the way I think they should be made. I'm going to show you how to make a perfect martini, a dirty martini, a pomegranate martini. We're gonna do tons of drinks, and it's gonna be a little short segment within the show. So let's get busy. This is the first episode of Season 3, and by a request from a fan, I'm gonna make the ultimate vegetable lasagna. Okay, and this lasagna is gonna be rich and decadent, and it's going to be very, very good. If you were to go out to a fine dining restaurant and order a vegetable lasagna, this is something that you're going to get, you know? So let's get busy, okay?
That we're going to need to make this vegetable lasagna, okay?
We're going to need a quart and a half of half and half. If you want to be truly vegetarian, use vegetable stock. This is chicken stock. I'm going to use chicken stock in mine. Okay? Or if you don't have vegetable stock or chicken stock, use another cup of half and half. Okay? I got salt to salt the water for the lasagna. Here's the lasagna noodles. I have onion powder, garlic powder, and Italian seasoning. I have a small onion diced into a small dice. I have a half a cup of Parmesan cheese. I have 2 cups of shredded mozzarella. I have a stick of butter, sweet, cubed, that's gonna go with a half a cup of flour. We're gonna make the roux again that I showed you how to make, but being that this is the first episode of Season 3, we're gonna make it again kinda quick. So I got the roux. I have salt and white pepper mixture for seasoning. I have a couple of tablespoons of a minced garlic in olive oil that I'm gonna use. I have 2 bags of spinach. Okay, I got a pot of water on. I got my pot going with my half and half in it. And the start of the show is gonna be the vegetables, okay? So this is broccoli, zucchini, yellow squash, and peppers, okay? And here I have a 12-ounce container of sliced mushrooms. And real quickly, I got a little film that I'm gonna show you how I did all of this. So, take it away. Okay, this is how I prepped the veg. Let's check this out. Okay, here's a bowl of my veg, okay? And these are the size pieces. I've cut the zucchini, the yellow squash, diced the peppers, okay? And I have sliced mushrooms. I sliced them into a slice that's kind of meaty, so they don't fall apart and there's a substance to them when they're cooked, okay? Now quickly, just let me show you, and I got broccoli here and I'm gonna show you how I did that. Okay, what I did was I took my zucchini
and I cut it in half. And then I cut it in half again, okay? And then I cut them into their pieces. Now roughly I have about 3 cups of zucchini, 3 cups of yellow squash, I have 3 medium-sized peppers that I'm going to show you. Okay, all my veg here. Okay, now this is all going to fall down when it gets sauteed. Okay, I did the same thing with the yellow squash. Anything that had really big seeds in it, I cut them out. Okay. Okay, just like we do with the peppers, right? We did all of this before, but I'm just showing you real quick that this is the first episode of the new season. Right? I'm going to cut them in half, and then we're going to take out the white. Remember, why do we take out the white? Because it's bitter. And we don't want anything bitter. Okay, that's good. Okay, I'm going to cut out that white. It's a good thing we have disposals down here in Florida, you know? Everything goes right into the, all this vegetable goes right in the sink. Okay, and then I'm going to cut them like this. And then cut them like this. Okay, I'm doing this real quick, because we've done this before. We're on season 3. You know, I have videos from season 2 on dicing, chopping, cutting the whole magilla. So, you know, you can go back and view those if you haven't seen them, if you're a newbie, or if you just started watching the show. Okay? So, there. Those are my veg. In my veg, I roughly, like I said, have about 3 cups of zucchini, 3 cups of yellow squash, 3 large peppers, okay, and then I got the broccoli. And I'm going to leave it in this whole head like this because you see here, okay, I'm just showing you this now because then we're going to get back to the video. See that there? I got a pot of boiling water. This is the same water I'm going to use to do my lasagna noodles. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop that in there like so, and I'm going to let that cook. Okay, I'm going to blanch that off because I want them to be a little bit softer. And then I'm just going to cut the flowerettes off of them to use in the vegetable lasagna. And what I'm going to do with the stems, I'm going to save them. I'm going to put them in the refrigerator, I'm going to put them in the freezer or something. I'm going to skin them, slice them up, and do that with a garlic and oil and a rigatoni. You know, rigatoni and broccoli and garlic and oil with some sliced sausage. Okay, remember, I always have my tools handy, right? Everything I need. Okay, I want this to come to a boil, and then I'm going to pull it off and chill it down. Okay, look, I got it boiling. And I'm blanching off the heads of that, right? Okay, I'm going to turn this water down on low because I'm going to cook my lasagna noodles with it. I'm going to put it in my sink in a little strainer. And I'm going to chip one of them into some cold water. There's the dog pound. Like, without my dogs barking, it's like a day without sunshine. Okay, so now I'm going to take this here, I'm going to strain it out, take that water off of there, okay, and I'm going to cut these heads off. Okay, and then I'm going to cut them into smaller pieces, like so. Okay, so you got some, you can see them when it's in your, okay, now
I'm gonna do that to another head, and then we're gonna get back to me.
Hey, showing you where to go. I just want to show you. I got a 15 by 13 pan that I'm gonna be putting the lasagna in. Okay. And I just wanted to, I got my pot of water going here for the lasagna noodles. Not going to use many of them, we're just going to wrap it in the noodles. Okay? I have my 6 cups of half and half hot and ready to go. There's nothing added to it but half and half. We're going to put this all together. Okay? I got my pan getting hot on the fire to make the roux. Oh, we're going to make that roux kind of quick. Okay? I got my little whisk, and we're going to get going. Hey, you know, this is a complicated dish to make, but if you set it up and do it easy, you know, it's not that bad. You could actually even make it in stages. You know, it's actually 12 o'clock. I have company coming over tonight. We're going to eat this at 6. I'm going to set it up, get it all ready, and then I'm just going to have to bake it in the oven and check it twice before I pull it out of the oven. So it's going to allow me time to spend with my company. Okay, like we made the roux the last time. Okay, I got a stick of butter, sweet butter, in the pan. We're gonna melt that down. Okay, and like I told you before, there were different stages of roux and different colors of roux. Okay, roux is a thickening agent used to thicken soup, stock, sauces, gravies, okay? So we're going to melt this down. Now I'm going to make a blonde roux. A blonde roux is the lightest color roux you can make. You can go into darker roux, they call them chestnut and some a couple of other names they call these darker roux, that will add a flavor to your to what you're doing. But I don't want to add a flavor. I just want to use this to make a blonde roux to thicken stuff. Okay, see I got that going? I got approximately a half a cup of flour. I'm going to put it in a little at a time, and we're going to see how that's going to go. Okay, let me take that off the fire because I don't want it to boil over. So that's going nicely. See that? This is how easy we're making a roux is. You put in the flour, and you mix it up. Okay. So there you go, that's a half a cup of flour. We're gonna let this cook just a little bit. I want it to stay blonde like this. You see the color? It's kind of like a blonde color. And that's basically all she wrote. That's all I want. No seasoning, no nothing goes in this. This is it. I'm turning the fire off. Okay? I have a little container. Do you remember when I made that roux the last time in season, the beginning of season 2? This is my leftover roux that I have from that, which I'm going to use. It lasts in your refrigerator for months. Okay? As long as you keep it covered and cold. So I'm going to take this roux here, and I'm going to put it in this container, all right? I'm going to put it in the container. Okay, so I just put it in the container. I put my other roux on top of it. I'm going to use them, that roux, okay? So I got the roux done. Okay, give it a little wipe. Okay, now, for the bechamel sauce, okay? I got this going, it's hot, I'm going to get it going, it's going to boil in just a minute, but what I'm going to do with that now is I'm going to get that going, and I'm going to do my lasagna noodles. If you have trouble doing two things at once, or multitasking it, just do one at a time, and then assemble it when it's done. I just want to kill a little time here and get these noodles done. Okay, I don't know if I'm going to need all of these. But you know what? I'm gonna make them. Whatever I got left over, I'll make something else out of it. Okay, so I'm gonna put these in here.
like so.
Okay, got that box in there. Okay. Get these going. You know what? I didn't salt this water. I don't know if it's too late, but I'm just going to put a little salt in there. I should have salted the water beforehand. Actually, the water helps it boil a little bit quicker. Okay, so you know how we do it, man. We do it step by step. You know, somebody might not have ever cooked these lasagna noodles before, and you got to play with them, man. Because if you just let it sit in your pot, they're all going to stick together. You know, speaking of sticking together, maybe just a little bit of oil in that water. Okay. Now we want to cook these kind of al dente, not all the way, because this is going to bake in the oven for about a half an hour or so. Okay, now this is coming up. Hear it, this is going to start to boil. Okay, now inside the bechamel sauce, we're going to need probably about 2 teaspoons of salt and pepper. So I have a salt and white pepper mixture that I mix. Most restaurant guys have this set up, and they always have a salt and white pepper mix ready to go. So you see that it's starting to come to a boil. And that's what I want, but we gotta keep our eye on these noodles. Gotta keep turning them. Right, they're boiling away in here. I possibly should have had a little more water in this pot. See this? I don't want that to happen. Save that in the nick of time, right? So I'm going to turn this flame down because it's really going. Or my electric, call it a flame. Okay. And now I'm going to take my nutmeg. Open that up. And we're going to put in probably about a teaspoon and a half of nutmeg. Okay, we're going to mix that in. Okay, we're going to mix that in like that. We got to mess with the noodles. Like I said, if you're new to this game, do one thing at a time. Okay? You want to make it so you don't want to break them either. You want them to stay whole. You want these noodles to be whole. But you want to make sure that they're not going to stick together and they're not going to stick to the bottom. Nothing worse than pasta stuck to the bottom of the pan, right? Okay, see this here? Now I got this going. This is going to go quick. I'm going to take my roux, and I want to thicken this up. So I'm going to put in probably about 2 tablespoons of roux in there and start to see how that goes. So I got all this crap on my counter here showing you what the ingredients are. And I would like it if it was just a little bit cleaner. So maybe after I make this, I'm going to clean it up a bit. And then we're going to come back to finishing this dish. Okay, now we gotta let that boil. I got that in there. We're gonna let that boil to get thick to see how thick it gets. Because again, I'm gonna enrich it with my stock, so I gotta thicken it. When I get it to a point where I see how, see that here? It's starting to get like sauce-like consistency.
just thicker than the half and half. Okay, so now I'm going to add slowly my stock. Oh yeah, there's a lot of goodness in that stock, I tell you. Okay, now back here to the pasta. Flame up on high on my bechamel sauce. We're going to split this bechamel sauce into parts, and then we're going to saute the spinach, and we're going to put that in a pot that we're going to use to top the lasagna. And that's going to have mozzarella and Parmesan cheese mixed in with it, and that's going to be the top of our lasagna. So that's going to be awesome. Okay. Now my noodles are working nicely here. Let me see if I can show you. They're still hard and hot. Okay. They're probably going to take a good 7 minutes. But you know what I'm going to do is, after I finish this sauce, I'm going to fade out and then come back to when those are done, and I'm going to pull them out of there, because I don't want to spend 7 minutes on nothing, you know? You know, but this is when I'm gone, this is what you want to keep doing. You want to just keep stirring them around and mixing them around. Okay, so now here, it's starting to get thick, starting to boil. I see the bubbles popping up on it, right? Okay, so we got our salt and white pepper in there, and we have our nutmeg in there. Okay, now what we need to do is we need to add some more roux. Okay, so I'm going to add another tablespoon and another tablespoon. I added two more tablespoons in there. This is all, what I'm telling you, this is all done by feel. You know, there's no exact recipe for this. Okay, back to my lasagna, move it around. You don't want it sticking. It's getting close. I may not have to. Okay, now look at my bechamel. Look how thick it is, and look at the way it's boiling. Let me show this to you. You see the way that's bubbling like that? That's the kind of consistency we're looking for. The way it boils like that. You see this? Okay, so we're going to give it another minute or so on the fire, let it come to a complete boil, and then I'm going to push it off to the side. Okay, you see that? That's exactly what we want. This is the mother sauce to make anything you want to make that's white. Okay, so that's done. So here, let's go over to our lasagna noodles. See what we got going on here. See, the key is to keep moving them around, right? Because if you keep moving them around, they're not gonna stick and they're not gonna break. Hey, welcome back. I just turned these down, and I'm going to take them off the fire. Let me show you what they look like. Okay, they're limp, but they're not, they're just about a little bit more than al dente, I'd say. You know, so here, let me get this here. I'm going to pour them in the sink. Into my colander.
the soap. Make it an easy cleanup for later. Okay, move that out of the way. Okay, cold water on the noodles. And this is what they're like. You see. Perfect, just the way I wanted them, okay? Not quite done, and not quite al dente. They're in between al dente and done, okay? So I'm gonna reserve these to the side, and we're gonna be back in a second and start to do the vegetable and show you what we're gonna do with the bechamel sauce and how we're gonna put this all together, okay? I did a little bit of cleanup. You know, and I'm ready to go now. I got the bechamel sauce here, right? Now what we're gonna do with the bechamel sauce is we're gonna take our Parmesan cheese, our Parmigiano Romano. We're gonna put that in the bechamel, and we're gonna mix that in. Okay. Now, you know something? If you wanted to make this vegetable lasagna and you didn't want to do this bechamel in the way that I'm doing it, this is like really, really high-end way. You could do it with just ricotta cheese and mix, you know, a couple of eggs in the ricotta and make the base that way. But I think that this, when it bakes in the oven and the top on with it's just a phenomenal vegetarian lasagna, and you're really gonna like it. So I got that going there, right? And now I got the 2 cups of mozzarella. Okay, I'm gonna put them in kind of slowly. Let's get that in there. That's all gonna melt down. Okay. Whoa. Look at this. Absolutely phenomenal. Smells delish too. Okay, let's get the rest of that mozzarella in there. Okay. That's a low-skimmed mozzarella. You could use whole milk, whatever you want, you know what I mean? And with the vegetables, you could use whatever vegetables you'd like to use in this. You know, it's totally up to you. The key to what we do here is you see the technique, you know how to do it, use your imagination and put your imagination together, you know, to come up with the combination of vegetables that you like, you know? I mean, if you really wanted to get fancy, you, in the middle of that, you could layer it, you could put chopped asparagus in a layer, you know what I mean? There's all kinds of things you could do. But, you know, I didn't want to go wild on the expense, because this is kind of an expensive lasagna to make. I mean, the vegetables aren't cheap. Zucchini, yellow squash. I'm gonna taste this. Wow, tastes perfect, because you know what? Now I'm gonna split this up and I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do. Okay, I got 2 bowls here. Right? Let me get that in there. I got 2 bowls. This big guy is going to get the majority of the sauce. A little more than 2/3. Okay? Actually, probably 3/4 of the sauce. Okay, here we're going to put in 1/4 of the sauce. I need my spatula. Let me get my spatula here. See, it's always great to have your tools around. Pots, pans, bowls, everything around you. My clean side of my sink, I keep bowls, pots, pans, all the stuff that I may need while I'm cooking so I don't have to run off and get it. Like you've seen me do so many times on other episodes. Now you see this here? I got the smaller amount here and the 3/4 of the amount here. Okay. I got my lasagna noodles here, right? Okay, now what we're gonna do is I'm gonna get my saute pan, okay? And I'm gonna hit it with a little bit of olive oil. I'm gonna turn that on, okay? I'm gonna hit this one with a little bit of oil, and I'm gonna turn that one on high. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start to saute the vegetables. But the key, you see these bags of spinach? Fresh spinach. You could use frozen spinach. You could wring out a chopped frozen spinach and use that. But this here, what we're gonna do, this is gonna be the topping on top of our lasagna. And I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do with that. Okay? I'm gonna take my onion, that's gonna be sauteed, and then all of these vegetables are gonna be sauteed. It looks like there's a tremendous amount of vegetables here, but when you cook it, they fall down a bit, you know? So I'm getting these pans hot. Okay, and I'm gonna make the topping first. So I'm gonna use half of these onions. For the topping, the other half are gonna go in the big side of the bechamel. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start to saute the vegetables. Okay, and in this one here, like I said, step by step, if the two pans are going to confuse you, do it one at a time. Then when you get all your stuff done, then you put it together, like I'm going to show you how to put it together. Okay, so I got the onions going, and you know what, I'm hitting both of them with a couple of teaspoons of garlic each. Okay? Okay, so I'm going to start sauteing these vegetables. I'm going to do it in batches because there's a lot of them there. Okay, I got that one going in this pan. Okay, I'm going to add some dry Italian seasoning. Hold up 1 second. I got to take the top off of it. I'm just going to put in just a little bit. A little bit. Okay, and that. I'm gonna mix these around. Okay, so I got a little bit of onion, the garlic, the vegetables, and the Italian seasoning. Okay. This is going here. Strong. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my spinaca, my spinach. Okay, it looks like a lot, right? Wait till you see when it's cooked down. Anybody that cooks spinach knows. Okay. Okay, we want to saute these pretty good, but not where they're mushy, because they're going in and they're going to cook. Okay. Wait till you see this spinach go down. I'm like a magician. I can put my hand over it, make a wand, and next thing you know, 3/4 of it is gone. But this lasagna is made with 100% fresh ingredients. And you could say it's 100% homemade, because nothing was made already that we used to make this. Thank you.
See, look at that spinach. Hello, where'd you go? Okay. Get that onion down in there. Like I told you too in the other episodes, you know, we're going to be doing a lot of stuff. But in this episode, we're going to do that eggplant rollatini, right? I'm going to make it with a ricotta and with a crab stuffing. And those are very freezable. I used to make them in my store, the crab stuffed ones. If you saw the pictures I just put up of my fish market and Italian deli that I had. I used to make that in there, and I used to make it in several restaurants. I used to sell quite a bit of it. Okay, see, that one's done. I'm going to put it in my bowl here. Okay, coming back over here. I'm going to hit it with just a tiny bit more olive oil. Not to make it greasy, just don't stick. I got these going here nicely. These veg. Okay, that's hot and bubbling. They get that bag in there. I was lucky, I got these on sale at Aldi's. The spinach, beautiful. 9 ounce bags of clean spinach. I got them at Aldi's this week. They had them on sale for 89 cents a bag. Wow, huh? Okay, you see that? These are done. This round's done. And I'm gonna put that in that bechamel. Okay? And then I'm gonna put that back on the fire. I'm gonna hit it with a tiny bit of oil. Just a tiny bit. You know, tablespoon and a half. Just to coat the pan. We're gonna hit this with the other vegetables. Okay, and I'm gonna hit this with a little bit of Italian seasoning. Just a little bit. Believe it or not, it goes a long way. Okay. Look at this spinach. What's the beauty of this is it's all going together, right? So you just keep using the same two pans. Made this in a long time, in a really long time. Okay, now I'm gonna hit this one with a little bit of garlic powder, just a tiny bit. And just a little bit of onion powder. Even though I had the garlic and the onion in it, I just want to give it just a little bit more. Okay? I'm done with this. So now that's going in to the other bechamel. Into the sink with that one. Okay? Okay? I got here. Now, ow, that's hot. That's hot stuff. Okay, I'm gonna mix this in. Beautiful, look at this. See this here?
That's going to be the top of our lasagna. Okay, when this bakes, man, maron. Okay. Gotta saute these up, keep it going. Okay. Let's get a look at that. It's looking good, huh? Look at all those colors. This lasagna is gonna be muy bueno. Whoops. You get a taste of that. Hey. Needs a little salt. Needs a little salt. Okay. So we're going to hit it with some salt and pepper. Some salt and pepper. Some salt and pepper. Okay. Got one more thing to do after these ones. Let's get it going here. Forgot about it for a second. A little bit of oil. And the mushrooms. And we're in. Okay. We are in. Okay, those go in. Done with that pot. Turn that off. Okay, let's get a look at that. Now we're gonna mix this up. See, I'm using my tongs for everything. That looks good. Wow. You know what I'm gonna serve? You remember the pesto that we made in last season? Well, you know why? Like I told you, that stuff lasts and it freezes really well. So tonight, before we eat, I got some bread. I'm going to slice that up, bake it in the oven, and I'm going to make a tapenade that we're going to dip our bread into, and it's going to be made out of the pesto and black olives. So I'm going to show you that also in this episode. Okay, now I'm going to taste that. Wow, that is good. That is good. Okay, let me taste this one. Let me get another spoon. Yum. That's good. Okay, now when you taste your stuff, you season it to the way you like it. You like it salty, you want to eat it, then you make it salty. If you don't want salt at all, you don't have to put any salt in it. It's all up to you. Okay? So I'm going to finish up these mushrooms here. It would help if I had the fire on, right? Okay, I'm going to just finish up these mushrooms. I'm going to add them to my mix, and I'm going to add them to this mix here. And then when I come back, we're going to do the assembly. Okay. You know what I'm going to do? As I was cooking these mushrooms up, I decided that I don't want them to get lost with the other vegetables. So I'm going to put them in with my topping. That's the beauty of this. You could do whatever you want to do and make it any way you want.
Okay, hey, we're here and we're going to assemble now, okay?
Now what I did was I let all of this stuff cool down for about 20-25 minutes. And in the meantime, what I did was is I utilized my time. I did a massive cleanup. I cleaned everything up, so I have nothing to clean up but these three bowls and pans that I'm using. Okay, so I got it all clean. It's almost 1:30. I've been taking my time with this. I actually went on my computer for a few minutes while I was waiting for that to cool down after I cleaned up. So now we're ready to go, and we're going to do the assembly. And what we're going to do is we're going to try to get into here and take just some sauce. We want to put some sauce down on the bottom of this. You know, of course you're going to get some of the vegetables, but that's okay. There's plenty of stuff here. Okay, we want to sauce this up. Okay. We're going to get a little layer of sauce in there. Okay. Doesn't have to be all the vegetables, but you want to try to get some of this, the sauce. Okay, you're going to get the vegetables. There's no two ways about it. But we want to put a little layer of sauce in there. Okay, we want that sauce there so our noodles stay on it and don't stick to the bottom. Okay, so getting out the sauce. And you know, you put about a quarter of an inch down. You know, get that on there like that, like so. Now I want to wrap this whole thing and then put the top on top of it. You'll see how that works. I never did it that way before, but we're going to try it. So here I got my noodles. Okay, let's see if we can get this. Okay. Okay, I got my noodles here. I'm going to show you. We're going to take them out. And also I want to tell you, if they stick together, run them under some warm water. And they'll come apart, and then you got to dry them again. Okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, okay, that's halfway, and that's going to come over the other half. Okay, so that's what I want to do. I want to overlap them a little bit, like so. Okay, we're going to put them in there like this. I think I'm going to use all of these. You know, so there we go, like this. And we're coming down to the end. If I have extras, I'm going to come out of the corners of them. Here, and here, and here. We'll see. Okay. Just to overlap them a bit. You know, I put those pictures up of my store. I used to make a seafood lasagna there. I used to put scallops, shrimp, and crab in it. Used to make it with ricotta and tomato sauce and mozzarella. It was very, very good. Matter of fact, a girl commented that I know, her brother used to work in my shop. And it was cool that, you know, to hear from people. Okay, now this is going to get wrapped over nicely. Okay, looks like I'm going to have it. I'm going to be able to do it. Okay, so I'm going to lay these over here like so. You know, this is what you want to watch, the assembly, you know what I mean? You know, you can make all of this stuff. You didn't have to make these noodles today. You could have made all of this stuff here, right? Put it in the refrigerator till tomorrow or the next day when you wanted to do it. Well, I'm not going to have enough. I wanted to. Let's see. I can go here with this one. Let's see, and maybe I could spread this out just a little bit and go there with that. Let's see how that works, okay? Good, okay, now I'm going to take my mix, and I'm going to put my mix in. To be sure to load it up with the vegetables. If the sauce stays behind, that's okay. because there's plenty. Yeah. You know what? I could do something with the sauce. You think of something to do. Serve it as a creamed vegetable. Whatever you'd like to do with it. Okay, now this is going to bake, and it should get thicker in the oven when it's baking. It's going to bake at about 300. I'm going to pat that down. It's going to bake at about 300 for about 25 minutes. Okay. Okay, look at that. That looks good, huh? Oh, wow. Did you see that? Have you been seeing that? There you go. I just been putting it in. Okay. That looks nice. Now, I'm scraping, not to get so much sauce in there, to take some more of the vegetable out. Okay. That's perfect. That's exactly what I want. Okay. I want to pack it down. Because I still got to put a topping on this, and then I'm going to have some of that left over also. You could have actually made this in a bigger pan, you know, but I'd rather have more than less. You know, that's my motto, I guess. More than less. Okay, now you see that there? Now, we're going to come over with the lasagna. Okay, you don't want to make it tight. You want it to be able to open up, so you don't want to make it tight. Okay, you see what I'm doing? See what I'm doing here? I don't care if you see me on the camera, I want you to see this. Even though I am charming and debonair. Okay, look at that. Now we're going to come across here. And then across there. Then we're going to fold these over. Beautiful. It's a winner. Winner, winner, vegetarian dinner. Okay, look at that. Now you see this here? We're going to fold that over. There's going to be plenty of noodle on the top. But it's going to be chock full of vegetables inside. Okay. See that? I'll press it down. Okay, now I want this other stuff here. I want this all over. I want it in the sides. I want it everywhere. Let me just rinse my hands. I'll be right back. My hands a quick rinse. Dry them off here a sec. Okay. Now, we're going to do the same thing with this. Okay. Let me get this going here. We're going to do the same thing with this. We're going to take the spinach and the mushroom, and we're going to put that all over the top. Now, you know what? There's a lot of cheese in this already. But if you wish, you may put more cheese on top. Make it any way you like it. Right on. Right on. Look at that. Whoa, this is going to be awesome. This is going to be a vegetarian's delight. And you know something? I'm going to love it. You know, and I'm certainly not a vegetarian. But I like my vegetables. And I like a polenta. I like all kinds of stuff. So I want the juice to get in the sides of this. See what I'm doing? I'm moving it away. I'm letting the juice fall down in between that. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, look at this. Now, what else do you need with something like this? We're gonna have a little of that crusty bread with the tapenade that I'm gonna make, and I'm gonna put this in the fridge because, like I said, it's 1:30. I'm not eating this until 5:30, 6 o'clock. This is gonna, I'm gonna take it out an hour before I'm gonna cook it. I'm gonna let it stand at room temperature. Then I'm gonna stick it in the oven. Okay, there it is. It's in the oven. It's got another 10 minutes to go. Okay. Then I'm gonna take it out and let it rest. Then I'm gonna cut it. Okay. There it is. It's been in the oven for 30 minutes. Okay, I'm gonna take it out. Ow, it's heavy. And I'm gonna let it set for a good 10 minutes before I cut it. And we hope it cuts really nice, and then I'm gonna plate it, and I'll show you. Okay, I just pulled it out of the oven, okay? And then I came in here and I cut it into 6 pieces, because there's... I got everybody else's plated except mine, and I'm gonna plate that one now and put that one on the show. Okay, so let's get over here. And these are the 3 pieces of zucchini that I sauteed to act as my garnish. So I have those 3 there, and this really comes out of the pan. Nice. Oh, and get some of that nice leftover vegetable in there like that. Okay, and then over here, I'm probably gonna put a piece of the garlic bread. This is a beautiful, beautiful vegetable lasagna. Get my fingers out of the way. See that?
Some call me Nicky and some call me Roman. Skeezer, please, I'm in a Ibiza. Just a season, I need my own sneaker. Sexy, sexy, that's all I do. If you need a bad bitch, let me call up yo. I'm going and I'm little many throats is out. I see some good girls, I'ma turn them out. Okay, bottle, sip, bottle, guzzle. I'm a bad bitch, no muzzle. Hey? Bottle, sip, bottle, guzzle. I'm a bad bitch, no muzzle. Let's go.
Music makes me